China's growth rate has slowed dramatically and has had a large impact on global commodity prices. For sure, the COVID zero policy and the litany of shutdowns and reopenings in major Chinese cities to contain the spread of COVID has been the main reason for the slowing of the Chinese economy. But there are other important challenges too that are in play and need to be understood. First, Chinese export growth is slowing because in a post-pandemic world, the US and European consumers are switching their spending back to services and away from goods. Many of those goods were produced in China. During the pandemic, when US and European consumers had to stay home, they couldn't travel, go to restaurants, so they switched their spending to goods to improve their homes, upgrade a home office, etc. Now the pendulum is swinging back the other way. Second, the Chinese economy has a heavy debt load, and the challenges in the property market continue to work as a serious drag on the Chinese consumer. Third, and a longer run concern, the Chinese population is no longer growing, and the labor force may decline later in the decade as the share of the over 65 age cohort continues to get larger and larger. While real GDP growth can be sustained by growth in labor productivity, once the labor force stops growing, economic growth will slow too. China averaged nearly 10% annual real GDP growth from the 1990s into the 2010s. But for the 2020s, growth may average more like the 3% to 4% of a mature industrial economy, still more than the US or Europe, but well off the former pace. The bottom line is that a slower growing China is not going to be the engine of commodity demand it once was. And as growth has slowed in 2022, commodities from copper to aluminum, from gold to oil have seen material declines from their peak levels earlier in the year.